going up to see the Marvel soon.
Pizza!
Pizza! You have the lunch pizza?
What's in it?
Oh, we're probably talking, Mommy. We are telling about, where's that roller? You can put your pencil up there.
This doesn't have big pencils.
They're like this
one. Oh, I know.
Look at
this. Dollar store.
You out of my way, G.
Oh, you don't.
You always complain about pencils being as sharp.
Tommy, it's me.
Come on, move it.
Ka ka ka. Hey, Poppy. Pizza. Pizza. My puppy. Pizza! This is Tommy's room. Pizza! Oh, my puppy dog. What? I'm for myself. My puppy. milk truck. Zooming on Sandy. I'm zooming in on you.
There's
pizza!
Pizza! You have the lunch pizza?
Look at it.
Oh,
we're probably talking, Mommy.
Where's that roller?
You can
put
your pencil
there.
This
doesn't have Santa cake. They
like this
one.
Oh,
We love our popcorn
at night.
No, George. New ones. You can eat your Orban Red and Walker, huh, Cheryl?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, okay,
well, you're ready.
No, not yet.
What do you think, Mark?
Oh, this is adorable.
Isn't that cute?
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, we're not going to have to touch it.
I know. I'll wash it anyway. Oh, my own. Oh, look. We can make our own.
Oh, I like this.
What is it?
They said they're illegal and they're going by parachute. This paramotor, they're going and they're leaving on top of their building. In New York,
the buildings that they work in.
Yeah, that's the only thing though. You know, wind gusts. Well, the motor will keep you going, but when you shut the motor off the land, you'd have to like really be caught under the power lines and stuff. That's what I worry about, power lines. Boy, that'll bill you fast. I'd like to have one.
Yeah, Brian, your place there. You can go out and play hold the back of the chute up for you. You know, Laura could do that. She'd have a pair of scissors in her hand.
Snip, snip.
Yeah.
Right,
you take off, fly around a little bit.
And then take
trees and stuff.
Oh, you bet. Yeah, if you have a good place to land, I really would love to try that. If we ever go away on vacation somewhere or anything, I'm gonna. And they rent those things. I'm definitely gonna try that. I wouldn't jump out of an airplane because the only reason I wouldn't do that is I don't trust somebody else packing my shoe.
Scotch tape, it is cheap.
Do you read your book, Mommy? Got you a duct tape? Getting ideas.
I don't know what you said. You've got a tape or so.
You ever go to that guy anymore with those stained glass windows or is he
Schmidt?
Is that his name?
Bob Schmidt. No, he's crazy, man. I remember we got that Windows England now.
So I remember we picked something up or...
Yeah.
That's something off.
That window upstairs. That one window upstairs. He did those too. Okay. He did them. But, it got crazy.
The dog or something.
The charity just had a bath.
Don't waste your film. Come on, Ma. Get the lead off. Go, we want to eat. We're waiting to eat. Not you. You wait to eat.
She's as big as a large cat.
Oh, happy holiday.
You gonna get satellite out there, George? You should get satellite. I'm waiting for that cable.
Well, it's taking them so long. And
years, and run over there.
They keep saying.
Yeah, but you can get satellite, though.
There you go. I'm with four kids. I don't watch much TV, so it's how
But you would if there was stuff on that you were interested in.
Yeah. Well, that's why we call it tape. Oh, movie. That's all I'm interested in.
I can't believe you guys like Poirot, man. That's one of the great shows.
I like Poirot.
Well, that's one of the great shows on TV. I wish they had more of them, you know?
Poirot.
I'm a better server anyway.
Tommy, make sure you sit on here, honey. This is kind of dirty.
Remember that St. Bernard, what was it called?
Charles Brody.
Yeah, remember?
True. Okay. M&M's on the tree.
Carol's making fun of my they're making fun of my $8 watch, you know?
I don't get cake.
Mommy, you drank one of Charlene.
And now you know why. Pretty good money on them, you know, even though they're really pretty.
their profit's pretty good on there. And I think I bought these worms came to $100. And there was another ornament that I saw there, and it was I think $16, and I was $4 short to get another ornament. Now I was already spending $100 there. I wanted to get one more. I was $3 or $4 short, and I said, I just looked down the street there. I said, ring this one up too. And I said, I'm not coming back up here today. I said, but when I come back up, like next week, I'll bring you the $3. You know? I said, I'll bring. Can you ring me up for all of these now? She said, no. I said, well, it's a good thing that I'm going to spend $100 here. I want to get this one, and I'm $3 short on this one ornament. And I'm not asking you to give me the $3. I said, I had to go home, wrap all this stuff, do this and that. I said, you're not going to let me slide on the $3. I said, I own my own home down there on Lincoln Avenue. I said, you're not going to let me slide for $3. And she said, no. I said, well, okay, I'm going to ring me up for these. I said, I'm going to put this one back. Usually, what's the advantage of living in a small community and everything like that?
Your mother was very the mother's sister. The first time we went in there, I spent a lot of Carol's on all these foreign ornaments and all that. And I said to her the rest of the week, we're glad that you have this shop here. It makes it more.
That's private owner.
Oh, people who live up there, they buy these. You know, when he was going out of business. And I bet she'd go in there and buy them and prop them up in
the old science fiction or in a case.
And people like
me. Remember, Rob, think you're getting a
lunch?
Lunch for a cup of you. He did Three Stooges and that. Midnight Matinee, they'd have that lunch.
They would.
I'm giving him my idea.
We had Larry on some witches. He had all those little movie posters. Then he did all the old, like Casablanca, and he did all Humphrey Bogart weekend. Then another weekend, he did something else. And what else did he do that was... But Mark's brother, that theater, he has like three shows a night. And Larry said, boy, he only knew then, what he knows now. But he had them all. He made a fortune showing those old movies. What else did he show? Old science fiction? Then he was the first one to show Fantasia after 40 years. It had never been shown in a movie theater. Walt Disney's Fantasia. I wanted to see it, and it was about 3 hours long. It was boring, the dog, and I fell asleep, but still, and he had them packed. We couldn't get in to see it. We had to wait for the next show.
Where is this?
The Guild Theater next to Heads Together.
It's a restaurant now.
Is it Clifty?
Yeah.
Clifty.
When I worked at Silks up there, and at that time, Ghostbusters was very popular, and they loved Ghostbusters, and they had posters up, behind the glass. So I went over and I saw the manager, whoever was in the lobby. So I went in the lobby there and I said, when you're through using, when the movie is over, can I have these posters? Because I know Tommy and Georgia would have been thrilled to get the posters from us. He says, oh no, he says, what we do with these is we send them to the next theater. That's going to be showing Ghostbusters.
Yeah.
Can't I just have one? No. We send them over to the other theaters.
Well, they make just so many, right?
Yeah.
So you share them among the theaters.
She told me, they say American Boom. I said, American Boom, man, that song all these landmarks. And the papers were getting after them. So they sold, which one was it? Radio City Musical.
Musical.
Yeah, so they stung in Jasper and pitched $150 billion to renovate that building. Jasper paid $150 million for it. There's another one they parked. There's a sword.
Well, that almost closed down. And had a renovated Radio City Music
Hall. Exactly. They bought a couple more in. The guys that owned them, the real estate people that owned them, they said, this is a big one, it's going to cost a lot of money. They said, we'll start with Jackson.
And they bid on it. When I was
perform.
A kid.
Oh, I took him up here.
Oh,
I didn't
see
him.
She has
an
upstairs.
There.
Oh, I'll just take that.
One of the first Ford dealerships in the country, one of the first, was on Long Boulevard. And that was on TV a long time ago. They showed the building, and I passed the building all the time. We lived in Coral Hill. And at the top of the building, Ford, how he used to, they
like I've seen that in your building, one on Main and Lane.
It's one I bought in 1918.
Yeah, that's the same. Yeah, it has a checkered floor, white and black tile checkered.
Well, this was one of the first. Because Pittsburgh, had all the wealthy people here.
Main and
Lane. It wasn't the first, but